the first week of school. Woo! In kindergarten and first grade, it is a ride. It is full of relationship building, routine making. You're starting to get to know your students. Your students are starting to get to know you. And you want to throw some academics in, and you want to be doing a whole bunch of things. But one thing that's super important is you establish the routine and the expectation of some read alouds. So today we're going to talk about 10 read alouds for that first week of school and how you can use them through the weeks ahead. Are you ready? Here we go. Hi, my name is Angie, and I was in education for 25 years, and I've read a lot of books to a lot of kids. And actually, reading time, read aloud time for me was my most favorite time of the day. I think the read aloud time is magical. Magical. And some of the books that I've selected to show you are not going to show up on any other list about the books to start your year off. Some are, because they're classics and I think they're super important, but some might surprise you. So let's take a look at the first one. And the first one is super dear to my heart. And you're gonna see why it's super dear to my heart. Can you see this? This is Morse the Moose Goes to School, and it is a well-loved book. It is actually the book when I started teaching back in 1989 that my students, my student of the day, always got to pick the end of the day read aloud. And this book was a favorite more than not. And so I am including this at the beginning of the year because Morris the Moose goes to school and he has all sorts of issues. And then, of course, there's a happy ending. But this is a kid favorite. And you can get this new, but I just wanted to show that to you because even though it's an old book, it really is a favorite for students. So Morris the Moose Goes to School. Say that 10 times fast. Book number two. Too Much Glue. When you're teaching kindergarten and first grade, there's an issue with glue. Now, you might be using glue sponges, which glue sponges are awesome, or you might be using glue sticks, which glue sticks are awesome, but sometimes you need to do glue. And I think doing glue bottles is a really good exercise for them. It helps with their muscle control, their muscle strength. They love using glue, so why not use glue? But is there such thing as too much glue?
Yes!
Yeah. I think some things that my kindergarten and first grade students made 5 years ago, they're probably still wet. But this book is awesome. You read it as part of your curriculum on how to use glue correctly.
Oh.
I think you're going to love it. The third book I want to share with you is actually a book that also teaches a skill. This, in this case, a math skill. And I think incorporating books at the beginning of the year, that first week, that have to do with skills that you're going to be working with in the classroom are really important. Books that are cross-curricular, so the reading with the math. And this one happens to be my favorite, and I'll tell you why. I know the author.
Hooray!
It's me. And my daughter helped to illustrate it. But this is a counting book, for lack of a better word. It's about a girl named Vashti, and she eats pancakes, and she puts blueberries on her pancakes, and pretty soon she just eats way too many pancakes. And her dad asks her, how many pancakes did you eat? And there's some adding. There's some count bys. There's some counting on. There's a whole bunch of math concepts in this book. The reason I included this is not just because I wrote it and I think it's an awesome book, is because once you read this, you can do a bunch of activities with this book. You can do it whole group and then put it in your station time. So it's truly a book that you can build on. And those are the kinds of books during that first week of school you really want. You want to establish some core materials that you can start building on as the weeks and months go by. And this happens to be one of them. So I hope you pick it up. I'll put the Amazon link in the description down below. In fact, I'll put an Amazon link for all of these down below. All right. The next one, Chrysanthemum. If you don't know this book, you are missing out. It is about a little mouse and her name is Chrysanthemum and she gets teased. And so a lot of times in kindergarten and first grade, names get teased, right? Also, talking about building on a book and some of the concepts that are in the book, at the beginning of kindergarten, at the beginning of first grade, I always did a unit about names and me and how they're special and how they belong and how we're all part of this classroom family. And their name is a huge part of it. And sometimes kids get their names poked fun at, right? If their name is super short, if their name is super long, if their name is super complicated, if they have a hyphen in their name, all sorts of reasons. And this book is perfect to talk about names and how special names are. All right? Check that out. One of my favorites. Next one, from one of my absolutely favoritest authors in the whole world, Robert Munsch. When I was first teaching, I actually had the privilege of hearing him speak in person at a reading conference. And he told the story of how he writes books for kids. He doesn't write them down at first. He actually thinks them out in his head, maybe does an outline, I can't really remember. And then he tells his story again and again and again to kids to see their responses, to see where they're engaged, to see where they're checking out until he gets a story that he's happy with. And this one is great, especially for kindergarten and first grade students, because if you can make it through the whole year without a kindergarten or first grader drawing on themselves, drawing on their neighbor, drawing on the books, on the desk, on the everything, I don't even know. You're just like super lucky and you should probably go buy a lottery ticket. But this is a story about a girl who uses markers, and I'll just let you read the book. All right. So good. A cornerstone of the first week of school. Next one is Monsters Love School. And this is one that you're probably going to find on beginning of the year reading lists for kindergarten and first grade. It's awesome. And, you know, it's just the story of monsters going to school and learning school etiquette and how school works and things like that. It's just really fun and super colorful. What I like about this book is there is so much you can do with it. You can make monsters afterwards. You can write your own monster words. You can do all sorts of things. All right. The next one is, and I don't have this book with me. I must have given it away. I've looked in my library, but it's a classic. And it's a classic for a reason. Brown Bear, what do you see? It's been around for a bazillion years. And again, it's a cornerstone book because there are so, if you can't find 200 activities to do around Brown Bear, then I don't know, but you're not looking hard enough. There are so many things that you can do with brown bear, brown bear. You can do writing with brown bear, brown bear. You can do transform it into whatever you want. Miss K's class, Miss K's class, what do you see? I see Jesse looking at me. Jesse, Jesse, what do you see? I see Rhonda looking at me. Okay? There's so many things. You have to have brown bear in your classroom. If you don't, you have to go get it right now. Okay? it's a non-negotiable. All right? As well as the very famous Chicka Chicka Boom Boom. All right, by Bill Martin and John Archibald. This is a powerhouse of a book. Again, so many activities that you can do with this book. And once you read it to your kids and they get the rhythm, they get the rhyme, they watch the movie. I mean, there are so many things that you can do with Chicka Chicka Boom Boom, and it will help with the literacy of your classroom. This one is a kindergarten classic, but I used this book in first grade as well. And we did all sorts of sight word activities around this book, art, all sorts of things, especially at the beginning of the year where some of those little first graders coming in are feeling a little unsure of themselves. And I just want to remind you, guess where I found this one? The Goodwill. Right? 99 cents. One of the best places to get books is at the Goodwill. So go to the Goodwill. If you can't find it, check the links down below. Remember, they're affiliate links. So if you purchase a book, then I get a small commission. You don't get charged more, but I get a few pennies because of your purchase on Amazon. Another one, look where I found it, Goodwill. Bad Case of Stripes. I love this book for the beginning of the year because it again talks about you being you and making, not hiding yourself, all right? And that all are welcome. I adore this book. I actually, when I taught, I would read this book several times a year. It is just, it's a must have, a must have. All right. And then there's also with Bad Case of Stripes, if you don't know, Screen Actors Guild here on YouTube, just type in Children's Read Aloud Screen Actors Guild. You are going to come to Storyline Online. I believe that's what it is. And that book is read by an actor, and the pictures, the book illustrations are so well done. And just another way, read the book first to your class, then sometime when you're having snack time or you need 15 minutes, put on Storyline Online and reread the book. Is it okay to reread books over and over again? It is. It is actually essential. In fact, if you don't reread a book at least 3, 4, 5 times, you're really not doing it justice. All right. The next one is Rufus Goes to School. And again, this is going to be on some back to school book lists, but it is just such a sweet book about a little pig who wants to go to school more than anything and is refused, but then finally finds a way to go to school. And I think your students are going to love it. It's very funny. All right. And number 10. This is also on like every back to school, kindergarten, first grade list because it's a classic. It's been a classic for a while. Pete the Cat, Rocking in My School Shoes. There's songs, there's activities, there's artwork. You can read this book a bazillion times, sing the songs, do the chants, find some letters, do all the things. It is endless. It is, again, just like brown bear, chicka chicka boom boom. I would say those three are the cornerstones of your first week of school because you can do so many things with them from then on. You can build on them. All right. So in fact, here's like, here's some little readers that I have left over from when I taught Do I ever throw anything away? Never. You never know when you're going to need Pete's shoes, little readers. Now, as a bonus, this is never going to show up on a back to school list. And that is just these little like readers like this, like these little teeny readers. I used to read these aloud to my students, like one or two a day, so that they knew the story, because these little readers are going to start showing up in their book boxes, at station time, at all the things, in homework take-homes, all the things. And while these are not great literature, they are so important for them to understand the story and the structure that these readers use, because these books are the workhorse of teaching them to read. And so why not use these as a read aloud every once in a while too? It's literally going to take you 2.5 minutes to read this, and they need to have the exposure for this. Don't just throw these at them. Show them how to use them. Show them how to point. Show them the cover. Show them. They're perfect for that kind of thing. Okay. All right. Those are my top 10/11 books for the beginning of kindergarten and first grade. I hope the list surprised you, and I hope it also confirmed some of the books that you want or have for your classroom. My name is Angie, and I was in the classroom for 25 years. Remember, the creator of the universe loves you, and I think you're pretty amazing too. I will see you next time. If you don't know when next time is, hit the subscribe button and the little bell, and you'll get notified. At least I hope you will. I will talk to you later. Bye-bye.